Next is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, first chapter, text number 40, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on July 28, 1973, in London, England.
Translation: when irreligion is prominent in the family, O Krishna, the women of the family become corrupt. And from the degradation of womanhood, O descendant of Vrishni, comes unwanted progeny.
This is a very important point. For good population. Without good population in the society, gentlemen, culture, educated, following the rules and regulations of religious principles, how you can expect peace and prosperity? That is not possible. So, the whole Vedic system was meant for having very good population. Not such kind of population who are addicted to killing and drinking and so many other sinful activities. No, then you cannot check. If such population is there, then everything will be polluted, especially nowadays, because there is one top good population and they go in the government. And how you can expect good government, good administration? The whole population is polluted. Therefore, in such a great state, USA, the president is being tried and is being criticized. So there must be good population. So to have good population, the woman should be very chaste. That is the basic principle of Vedic civilization. And to keep the woman chaste, it was the function of the responsible father, or in the absence of father, the elder brother. He must get the woman, the girl, married. It is compulsory. There is no compulsory for man to marry, because a man may remain brahmachari. By training, he can abstain from sex. But if woman is not protected very strictly, it is very difficult. It is very difficult. Chanakya Pandit has, it is not, it is, we are discussing Shastra, don't think otherwise. Chanakya Pandit says, Vishasa naiva kartavyam, strisu rajakulesu. Vishasa naiva kartavyam. Don't trust woman. Vishasanaiva kattabham strishu. Strishu means woman. Rajakul and politicians. Yes. Vishasanaiva kattabham strishu rajakulesu. Never trust the politician and woman. Of course, when woman comes to Krishna consciousness, that position is different. We are speaking of ordinary woman. Because Krishna says in another place, Sriya Vaishyas Tatha Shudra. They are considered women, Vaishya, the mercantile community, and Shudra, and the worker class, they are less intelligent. Bapujoni. When the progeny is defective, then they become less intelligent. So Krishna says, Manghi Pathava Pasitya Jepishu Papajuna. Sriyavishyasatha Sudra Stevijanti Parangati. Him, Papajuni, degraded birth. Him, Oman, Sudra, and Vaishya, they also can become fully Krishna conscious by training, and they can also go back to home, back to Godhead without any check. So, when we study things from material point of view, these things are to be taken care. But when a man or woman becomes Krishna conscious, he or she takes care of herself or himself. It is spoken, Arjuna is speaking of ordinary woman. Srisu Dushtasu. Just like Adharma Abhi Bhava Adharma. If the woman is trained, a girl is trained from the very beginning that you should remain chaste. That is dharma. It is called satitva dharma. Sati means chastity. There are many stories of sati, chaste woman. Naladamayanti. His husband became so poverty-stricken. He was king, but he became later on so poverty-stricken that he had no sufficient cloth. So the husband and wife was putting on the same cloth, half and half. So still there was no divorce. You see? Still the woman did not consider, she was also king's daughter. But the husband has fallen down to so much poverty-stricken condition. So why shall I live with you? These are some of the extreme examples of chastity. Not to speak of olden days, I have seen in Bombay in 1935 or 34, on the roadside there was a beggar. The beggar, the face was defaced, might be some accident. His eyes and everything became defaced. He could not see, everything being useless. So he was sitting on the roadside, and his wife also sitting. But I saw that beggar was neat and clean, the wife was also neat and clean. The wife's business was that to keep the husband always neat and clean and fresh and bring him there and again taking at home young woman. So I could understand that his wife is so chaste. She has not left such ugly husband because his face was defaced, and helping him because they require some money. So we have seen. There are many stories of chaste woman. Many stories. There was one disciple of Ramanujacharya, very poor. So Ramanujacharya came in that poor disciple's house, and he saw there was no one in the house. So he thought, what is this? This is my disciple's house, this family man, why there is none? That means he could understand that the door is not locked, door was closed only, then he could understand that within the door his wife is there. Therefore, he knocked the door, and there was response also knocking, but she could not come out. That means she was so poor that she had no garment. She was keeping herself within the room naked. So Ramanuja could understand that there is his wife, maybe she has no sufficient clothing. So immediately his own clothes he gave within the room. And the woman came out putting on that and then offered obeisance. So he could understand the position that very, very poor, even no clothing. So after putting on the cloth, he went to the grocer's shop, because Ramanujacharya is there, she must receive. Grocer's shop. The grocer knew that this woman is very woman, very poor. So his business was to entice her. But she never agreed. Although she was young. Now this woman went to the grocer's shop that you know that I am very poor. I require immediately some grains, ghee and other things. My Guru Maharaj has come at home. I must receive. So tonight I agree with your proposal. Please give me. Even at the sacrifice of my chastity, I want. So the grocer was very glad. This woman I conversed and tried to induce her. She never agreed, and now she is agreed. So, all right, you take, whatever glad, take. So she has given all kinds of food grains, as much as she wanted, and she cooked and gave to the spiritual master and his associates, his servants. Everything was very nice. In the meantime, the husband came working whole day, and he saw that everything was nicely done. Guru Maharaj is paid and his associates are paid. So he asked his wife, how did you get all these things? Then she narrated the whole story. Then the husband also said, yes, you have promised. All right, take some prasadam and go to him. Because you have promised to meet him this evening, so go. Then the grocer heard the whole story and his mind became changed. Such a chaste woman, such a faithful. See, you are my mother. You take more ingredients, grains, as much as you like. So there are still, that is not very long ago. So this was the training. And the psychology is that woman, the first man she meets, and if she is kept carefully, she becomes staunch lover. This is psychology. There is good psychology in maintaining the society. Therefore, a woman, especially in India, especially in Bengal, before attaining puberty, she was married. Not to meet the husband, unless she attains puberty. But she remained at father's house. But she must know that I am married, I have got husband. This psychology. Then she becomes very chaste. Because she thinks of her husband and becomes more and more devoted. So this arrangement that woman must be married before puberty. Or if not puberty, she must get a husband. So in this dharma, it is called kanyadar. Kanyadar. Kanyadar means it is very obligatory that the father must get the daughter married. This is dharma. So, if this dharma or this religious principle is violated, that is, Arjuna is marking, adharma bhi abhi bhava, when people become neglectful of the family tradition and religious principles, adharma abhibhavat, Krishna pradushanti kulastriya. Kulastriya. Kulastriya means, kula means family. And striya means woman. So woman must be belonging to a respectable family. Therefore it is said kulastriya. Not society girl. Kulastriya. Of the family. We have got experience in our college days. I was sitting in a friend's house and one sweeper, woman, sweeper with broomstick and with what is called covering, she was standing, say about 20 years distant from her sitting place. So I asked my friend that, this sweeper woman wants to come in. She is waiting because we are sitting. She is ashamed to come. So let us come. So we stood separately. That means although she was a sweeper woman, still we had to honor her to enter. We stood up separately. She was feeling that how can I go between two men? And this we have seen in our... So this is Vedic culture. Women should not be allowed to mix with men. Not allowed. In Japan also, the same system. Before marriage they can mix. But after marriage, they cannot mix. In Japan also, I've seen. But in India, still, the system is there. Woman, without husband, cannot talk with any man. That is also psychological. In the Bhagavad, it is stated that man is like ghee, butter pot, and woman is like fire. Therefore, as soon as there is fire and butter pot, the butter pot must melt. Therefore, they should be kept aside. These are the statements. And the Shastra says that in a solitary place, you should not remain even with your daughter, even with your sister, even with your mother. Matra sasra duhitrava nami vittasane vase balavan indriya grama vidyamsa vikarsati. Either your mother or sister or daughter. Nobody becomes lusty with mother or sister or daughter. But Shastra says, even your mother or sister or daughter, you should not live in a solitary place. Then one may question how it is possible. No. The Shastra says, balavan indriya grama. The senses are so strong that it becomes polluted. Now it may be some rascal fools may be polluted like. No. Shastra, Vidhan Savikarsati. Even the most learned, he can be polluted. So sometimes, in India, I am criticized that I keep woman and man in the same temple. In India, there is not a law. No man can leave at night. They can come and go. But I defend myself that this is the system of the country, the woman and man, the intermingled. How can I check then the woman? Shall I not give them any chance for chanting Hare Krishna? No, I shall do this chance. I shall give this chance to woman even at the risk. That is my request. So therefore, chastity is very, very important thing for producing good population, nice population. So unless the population is good, if the population become hippies, then how there can be any peace and prosperity? Therefore, to produce children, there is sanskar. First sanskar is garbhadhan sanskar. This is called kuladharma. Garbhadhan sanskar means when especially the high caste, brahmana, kshatriya, especially, Shudra has no sanskar. Only the higher class, brahmana, kshatriya, and vaishya. Vaishya also sometimes no sanskar. But brahmana, kshatriya must have sanskar. Dasavidha sanskar, 10 kinds of sanskar. One of the sanskar means purificatory method. One of the sanskar is also marriage. One must get married. So, before the child is given birth, there is sanskar. What is called garbhadhan sanskar. It is not that the husband and wife mix without any restriction and have sex life at any time. No. You know that mother of Hiranyakashipu, Kashyap Muni, I think, father. So, see, the woman became very much sexually excited. And the husband replied that this is not time, this is very bad time, evening. Why you are insisting? But she was too much lusty, and because the husband was obliged, Hiranyakashipu was born. A demon was born. Therefore, there is garbhadhan sanskar. To find out when the husband and wife should mix and give birth to a child. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita, I will see that sex life, which is according to the principle of religious ideas, that is ayam. The sex life is not bad, provided it is executed according to the religious principles. So garbhadhan sanskar, just what is the idea? The idea is the child born must be first class. He'll be able to become Krishna conscious, he'll be able to understand the shastras, the Vedas, he must have the good brain. These were the ideas. But if they are not born in that way, like cats and dogs, that is called varna-sankara. You cannot specify whether he is a brahmana or a kshatriya or a vaishya or a shudra. That is called varna-sankara. So varna-sankara population is not good. Varna-sankara. No caste. No definition to which class this man belongs. So at the present moment, because these purificatory processes are not accepted, even in India, except when they are unable, everything has topsy-turvy. Therefore, the Shastra says that accept everyone as Sudra. Kalo Sudra Sambhava. There is no more Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya. All Sudras. You have to accept. Because no Vedic culture, no Garbhadhan Sanskar. They are born like cats and dogs. So where is this division? There cannot be. Therefore, accept them as Sudra. Varnashankar is less than Sudra. So at least Sudra they should be. So there is no Vedic Dikha. For Sudra, there is no Dikha. There is no initiation. See, initiation is meant for the persons who are born in Brahmana family, Kshatriya family, or Vaishya family. The Sudra has no initiation. So in India, there are professional gurus. They initiate Sudras, but do not eat foodstuff touched by the disciple. So there are so many things. If he is initiated, how he can remain Sudra? But they keep him Sudra. At the same time, they become Guru. So Sanatana Goswami gives direction in the Hari Bhakti Vilas that Tatha Dikha Vidhanena Dijatam Jayate Nina. If properly initiated, he becomes immediately Brahman. Dijatyam. Vija means second birth. Yatha kanchanatang jati, kamsa raso vidhanaka. There is a chemical process that kamsa, bell metal, can be turned into gold by mixing with proportionately mercury. Now here is a hint of chemistry. If anyone can prepare gold, but it is very difficult to mix mercury. As soon as there is little heat, immediately the mercury is finished. So there is a process. Everything has process. Many yogis know how to make gold from copper. Chemically, copper, tin and mercury, if you mix proportionately, it will be gold. So, Sanatana Goswami gives this example as the copper and tin, these two metals mixed with mercury, there can be production of gold. Similarly, by proper initiation, by the proper spiritual master, one, Sudra, even though he is a Sudra, less than Sudra, Varnashankar or Chandala, he can become Dijo. Brahman. So our process is to make Dija Pancharatri ki vidhi. That is recommended. Shruti Siti Puranadi Pancharatri ki vidhi vina. Uikanti ki harer bhakti utpataye vakalpate. Rupa Goswami gives this direction. That the initiation must be done according to Shruti, Sriti or Pancharatri. There is Naya Prasthan, Shruti Prasthan and Smriti Prasthan. To make spiritual progress in three ways. By the Vedanta philosophy or Vedic ways or according to Smriti. Smriti means authorized books written in accordance with the Shruti, Shruti Sriti. Just like Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is not directly Vedas, but all the stanzas of Bhagavad Gita, they are strictly according to the Naya Prasthan and Shruti Prasthan. So any book which is strictly written according to the Vedas and Vedantas, that is also accepted as Vedic literature. So Pancharatri ki vidhi means that it doesn't matter whether man is Sudra or Chandala. Chandala means less than Sudra, Panchama, the fifth grade. First class Brahmana, second class Kshatriya, third class Vaishya, fourth class Sudra, and below this fourth class, they're all Chandalas. Chandala means Panchama. untouchable. They are called untouchable. So in the untouchables, because Krishna has said, Manghi Partha Bapasita Jeepishu Papujuna. The Papujani Chandal means Papujani, born of low grade family. The Bhagavad says, Sukadeva Goswami says that Kirata Hunandra Puninda Pukkasa Abhira Sumbha Javana Khasadaya Javana Mlecha Javan. They are called they are also counted among the chandalas. Jennecha papa, even lower than that. Jennecha papa. Shuddhanti, they become purified. How? Prabhu Vishnavi Nama, when they are initiated to become Krishna conscious. So if one may argue, how it is possible to make a chandala a Vaishnava? No, that is possible. Prabhu Vishnave Nama. Vishnu is so powerful, omnipotent, he can do that. So only by Vishnu mantra, by becoming a Vaishnava, one can transcend all these restrictions, sociology. You can understand? That is confirmed by Krishna. Manchabhya Vicharini Bhakti Yogena Jasevate Sagunana Samatitta Itana Brahma Bhuyayaval. Immediately. He transcends. He is in the Brahma platform. One who has taken very seriously this devotion and service. He is no more on this material platform. So long we are in the material platform, these distinctions, Brahman, Kshatri, Vaishya, Varnashankar, they are considered. But when one is transcendentally situated, simply in pure, unalloyed service of the Lord, he is no more in the material platform. He is in the spiritual platform. Brahma Bhuyayakalpa. He is only in the Brahma platform. Brahma platform means Sagunana Samatitta Eta. This material platform means three modes of material nature. Satogun, Rajagun, Tamagun. Here in one is Brahmana. Satogun means the Brahminical qualification. He is also contaminated. He is also contaminated. He is conditioned by the material nature. And what to speak of Sudra and Varnashankara. Everyone is conditioned by the material nature. Devijjhesagunamai. Well, Brahmana means to be situated, a first-class prisoner. A first-class prisoner is also a prisoner. You cannot say that he is free. No. Free is different from a first-class prisoner. Sometimes any respectable gentleman, some political offense, he is put into jail, just like Gandhi also went to jail and so many others. But they are given the place, first-class prisoners. They got servant, they got separate bungalow, and books, library, all facilities, but they cannot go out of it. They are called first-class prisoners. So, to become a brahmana means to become a first-class prisoner. So our point of view is not to become a first class prisoner, to get out of the prison. That is Vaishnava Vishnu. In fact, last night I have given comments. The Madhavendra Puri, he was performing the Annakoot ceremony and installing the deity. So everything was being Brahmana, done by Brahmana, qualified Brahmana. But Madhavendra Puri initiated them again to become Vaishnava. Then he gave them in charge of the deity world. So the Vaishnava functions cannot be done even by a Brahmana. Even one is qualified Brahmana. He is unfit to propagate Vaishnava philosophy. That is stated in the Shastra. Sat karma nipuna vipra mantra tantra visharada. A Vaishnava guru nasasyat. Syat Vaishnava sapacho guru. Sapacho means chandala. Who was eating dog. that is considered the lowest. There are different kinds of meat eaters. But in India, the cow place it as their dharma. Some of them are eating hogs, even dogs, but there was no government will not allow to eat the cow flesh, no. That is not. If you want to eat flesh, you can eat hogs and dogs and other goats also. But you cannot touch a cow. This is restriction. First of all, they should not be meat eaters. But if you are staunch meat eaters, then you cannot touch cow. You can eat some other animal. That is sapacha. Sapacha means the dog eaters. In Korea and some parts of there, they eat dogs. They sell dog flesh publicly. So in India also there is a class. In Assam side, they eat also dog. So the dog eaters, they are considered lowest of the mankind. So there is a sapacha. Sa means dog, and pacha means who cooks. Sapacha means chandala. If a man from the sapacha family or the chandala family, he becomes a Vaishnava strictly according to the orders, then he can become guru. But not a brahmana if he is not a Vaishnava. This is the distinction. Even one is born in the family of a brahmana, and he is not only born, he is qualified. Satkarma nipuna. Nipuna means qualified. Brahmana has got six kinds of occupation. He must be learned himself, he must be able to teach others Vedic literatures, that is called pathana pathana. Then he must worship, worship means demigods, or they consider that any demigod or god the same, some impersonalist. So jajana jajana, there are other also religious ritual functions they perform, that is called jajana. Jajana jajana and dana pratigraha. A brahmana takes contribution. A brahman is never engaged in service like shudra. That is shudra's business. So these are called dharmas. There are so many departmental dharmas. So Arjuna is referring to this. Yes, adharma vibhavat Krishna. When these principles are sacrificed and there is awakening of adharma, irreligious principles, then the result will be adharma avivavat Krishna pradushanti kulasriya. Then the stricture will be withdrawn and the family women and women, they will be polluted. And as soon as the woman is polluted, strishu dushtasu, the woman is polluted, brasneya, my dear Krishna, jayati varna sankara, then the whole population will be varna sankara.